Hello everybody, it's Eva from Bohemian Crafting here again, and today I'm coming to share with you a step-by-step tutorial how you can create a journal or book using envelopes, using old book pages, and using probably some boxes, or as I've got here from very old photo album. You know, these photo albums where you just stick your photos under this acetate piece. I've got this page, and I really like that page. It's strong and it has those holes, so I probably gonna use this one. So prepare some envelopes, any kind of sizes. If you've got this DL, I'm gonna show you how you can add to your journal or your book something like this. This I made for my tea as giving envelope for teas to my friends and to my colleagues. And I was thinking that, I can use it in some book for photos, for some ephemeras. So I'm gonna show you how we can create this one. It's from DL envelopes, these long ones. So prepare yourself some envelopes you've got. If you have old book pages, use them, because I think this is much more easy to use than if you're gonna use decorative paper, some designed paper. There we are too scared to cut. But with old book pages, with old books, you know, every book, they've got around 100 or more pages. There is lots of material to ruin it. So use it. I believe it will be beautiful book. Use just this one without any photographies, without any ephemeras, because my printer is broke down, so I have to come up. I have to bring something what will be useful without ephemeras. So I'm gonna prepare myself and I will be back. So we're gonna start with those envelopes. I've got this window DL envelopes. I cut pieces of book pages a little bit smaller than it's my envelope. It has small gap all around. It's 1/4 inch smaller than its measurement of my envelope. So now I'm going to slide it in like this. And go there. Your smaller go there. Oops. If it will go this way, we will never finish, I guess. And glue your piece into your envelope. Just fix it there. And also glue down this flap. Like this. Both envelopes same way. So I put a book page to both envelopes and I glued them down. Now I'm gonna cut the edge, one edge of each of these envelopes. Because I'm using these window envelopes, I will cut one edge close to that window and another edge far from that window. And I'm gonna use this is paper trimmer from Lidl. It's, I think, that Orlando. Not Orlando. Crelando. It's this company. It sounds so close to Orlando. So I'm gonna cut just edges of my envelopes. You can use any paper punch. You can use decorative scissors. I'm gonna use this one because it's beautiful way. Like this. Go there. Oh, come on. Oops. Now, if you have scoring board, use your scoring board. If you don't have that, you will have to use your ruler and some tool for making score line. It's brilliant to use for that dinner knife with that not sharp edge. But I've got scoring board, so I'm gonna score it not on that cutted edge, on the opposite edge. Score 2 inches and 2 1/4. Similar way, do with that other envelope, 2 inches and 2 1/4. So that edge where we cut our envelope, it's not scored. We've got scoring lines here. Fold your scoring lines, and I think I scored that opposite way. Yeah, it can happen. Oh no, I didn't. Good, I didn't. Fold your score lines like this, and I wanna use also some stamping on my envelope. So I'm gonna use a background stamp I've got here. It's beautiful background stamp. It meant to be for Christmas, but I think the design, it's for any kind of occasion. This those stripes from Tim Holtz. This is from collection Stripes and Holiday. Oh, it's here. So this is that set of stamps. So I'm gonna use these stripes, and I'm gonna stamp both envelopes where it's that window, just on that place where is that window. So I will be right back. So I stamped both those these envelopes. I'm gonna distress edges a little bit, not too much, because I'm not sure how much grungy I wanna that book. Maybe I will distress it later a little bit more, but for now I'm gonna make just light distressing on all those edges, including inside edges, and I will be right back. Okay, I distressed all those edges a little bit, not too much, because I'm really not sure how grungy I will make that book. I'm gonna punch 2 holes on the edge here, and I'm gonna use this. This is proper office heavy duty hole puncher. So I'm gonna place my envelope like this, and I'm gonna make these 2 holes. It's a brilliant tool. It can punch chipboards. It also punch those MDF, I think it's called. It looks like wood. It's a very teeny tiny wood, so it punch that as well, and also plastics and all kind of stuff. So this is a really brilliant hole punch. And I'm gonna add eyelets, and I'm gonna quickly share. It was took me really 1 hour, more than half an hour, maybe 1.5 hours. I destroyed loads of my eyelets, but then I used them like embellishment on, you know, around to, oh my god, buttons. So I used those, destroyed eyelets like my embellishment. But I'm gonna show you how this works. Make a hole with this. Here you can choose the size of your eyelets. This is 1/8 and this is 3/6. It's for this size. So I'm gonna move it, that window here. It show you which hole you're gonna punch. Here is bigger hole, here is smaller hole. So this is bigger eyelet. So I'm gonna slide my cardstock here, and I'm gonna press it down, and it makes hole. And now, this was okay. I understood this one really well, but then I was totally confused from all these edges. I found for myself the most useful, this one. There is 3-4 sizes for myself. I found most useful this one, which is like sliding your eyelet to the sides, and here on this end you've got 2 different. You have to like slide it a little bit up, and then you can choose. This is teeny mini, it's for those small eyelets, and here I'm using this one a little bit bigger. And slide it back, and it will fix it to that point. Then when you want to fix your eyelet, move it to the front, this green thing. And now, I made loads of mistakes before. I realized that, oops, that's my fault, that it's not fault of this tool. I placed all the time my eyelid on this one, like this, because I thought this way it will it will fit it beautifully. No. You have to keep top of your eyelid up, and then if is it on the edge, you can just because I'm always not sure if I will be this is too far. I'm gonna make one more. Bear with me. I'm gonna show you. If you've got hole close to the edge, I'm gonna use it like embellishment later on. And you can fit the paper or your tag or envelope or anything where you wanna fit that eyelet here. If you can fit it here, it's good. If you will like click it on that pin, because then you will be sure that you press it at right, oh, in right point. Move it to the front. I'm sorry, this is a really bad presentation. And then press it. And when you've got hole a little bit far from your edge, or maybe in middle, don't worry, I'm gonna use it somehow. I'm gonna cut ducks out of it. If you've got your hole somewhere in the middle or far from that edge and you can't like click it on that, you can like click it because here it's paper. This paper, it's not gonna fit here. It's too long and I can't click properly on that point. It's good to position your eyelet on that. Oh, you can see that. On that, on this one, to see that through to that eyelet. I can't show you, can I? It's like you need to see that point and then press it down. It will spread your eyelet beautifully. You will don't destroy it. So this was kind of challenge for me. It took me a really long time and I was like, what I bought, how this works. I'm totally confused. But it works really amazing. It's a wonderful tool. So I'm gonna put eyelets to those holes. Oh, come on, stay there. Come on, don't fly away. And here I should be just enough. Yeah, click it on that pin, put it in, click it on that pin so I can't move it. You know, I put my eyelet around that pin and now I can press it and it's beautifully done. Maybe I can put eyelets on one side and on another side so I can put inside a large tag. But I was thinking, oh, it's good enough to have their tag like this. So this is really very easy tool. I just didn't know how to use it. It was so funny. So if you don't know, you can make so many embellishments, you know. Before you will realize how this works. But it's a really wonderful, wonderful tool. So I put my eyelets on those envelopes. And now, put envelopes to your top side together. Oh, before you will do that, put the glue. Here we've got those two scoring lines. So put glue here on these three lines. Leave this open for pocket and then put your envelopes top by top together and face these two together, and it will make your middle pocket between those two envelopes. And here we've got score lines, so it makes like spine of your envelopes. So you can, if you will make pockets here, they can be dimensional. You can put there tea bags like I did, or small chocolates. It can be like gift envelope. If you will tie it here with some ribbon, it will be beautiful gift bag. Here can be like gift card, and here make two pockets, and you will have beautiful gift bag for chocolates, for some treats. So this way I made my envelopes. Now I'm gonna make four of them, I guess. Four will be good for journal. I'm gonna make four of them. You don't have to see all that process. I'm gonna make four of them. I've got four envelopes. By the way, I was thinking, right now, when I try to put them together, I was thinking if you will make more of your envelopes this way, and then you will put them with your scored lines with these spines together and glue them on the cardstock, you will have wonderful photo album. You can use it like photo album and decorate it with some papers and embellishments. It will be very easy photo album. So right now I'm gonna prepare probably cover for my journal, and I chose envelopes because I want to create something from envelopes, and I found this paper, this beautiful cardstock from that very old photo book, photo album, so I'm gonna use this one as well. And because this is too big, I choose this envelope. It's that dimensional envelope which has those lines here. I already tried that. I'm gonna cut edge of this envelope because it will be one pocket on one side, so I'm gonna use just scissors. I'm not terrible, hopefully. We will see. I'm gonna cut edge of this envelope. Here will be one pocket, and I'm gonna open that envelope. And I think maybe it will be not same, but it will be not too big. I don't know. Oh, I forgot English word for the difference, probably difference of sizes. If I will put it like this. It's same! Yay! Good. Good. So I'm gonna use this one for make my cover stronger. You can use pizza boxes, boxes from Cerealis. And I've got size of my envelope. This is 15 and a half. If I will have 1.5 inch spine, which is good enough for journal, yeah, that's the average spine. So if I will have 1.5 inch spine, then the rest, it's 14 inch 7. Okay, I need to score this 7, 1.5, and that rest will be 7 as well. If you don't know how I came up, because, you know, I know I'm mumbling. So, all my envelope, it's 15 and a half inches long. I'm gonna take 1.5 inch for spine. I wrote it right. So, the rest, what I've got from those 15 and a half, it's 14. 14 inches is the rest, what I've got here. And that I have to separate for front cover and from back cover. It means, I don't know how you say this one. Two, it's 7. Okay? 7 inches. It's one side, 1.5 inch spine, and 7 inches, it's that rest side. And same way, I'm not gonna count this one. I'm just gonna slide it in. I'm gonna cut edge of this envelope as well. Will I had to stop my video because my son came to ask me for something. He's cooking potato salad. So I have to give him advice. So I'm gonna put this edge as well. That opposite edge. Then it's flop of my envelope because I'm gonna use it like pocket. And now I'm gonna score. First I'm gonna score that bigger envelope. So from here, it's gonna be, this will be top of my cover. I wanna have there on the cover, I wanna have some multifunctional pocket. A multifunctional cup cover. So I'm gonna score at 7. Oops, if I will get there, I'm gonna score on 7 inches and 8.5. That's gonna be spine of my book. And now, 2 pockets here with flops will be too much. Okay, I'm gonna have that cover a little bit crazy. So I'm gonna start scoring from this side, 7, and then 1.5 inch for spine. And that rest will be here on the front, and I will have to embellish that somehow to make it pretty. I will see. But yes. So 7 is on back. And 1.5, it's our spine. Okay. I'm gonna distress all edges and I will be back. So I distress all these edges and now, I'm gonna cut also this piece. It's a little bit deeper than those 7s. I need just 7 inches for front and 7 inches for, I will need 2 of them. I'm gonna prepare first 7 inches. 7, 7, 7. I wanna have there this whole edge in my cover. So I'm gonna face it this way and I'm gonna cut that end. Hopefully the knife is still working. Oh, it doesn't. Okay. It's all ready. I need a new knife. Here is straight. Ha! Here I've got mark. So I know. Hopefully this will work. Will that work? It's here. How this works. This way. Okay, good. Nice. Good. I got it. Nice job. Hey, I got it. Yay. Ta-da! That's good. I have to find that photo album with these pages again because I really like that. So I want to have this one inside, and it will make like pocket between this stronger piece and between my envelope. I'm not sure if I will already glue it down. Maybe I will. I will have to fold these to make sure it's gonna be straight. And if you're gonna work with envelopes, if you're gonna try this one, just remember to work with envelopes. It will sometimes give you a hard time when you fold envelopes this way. They are sometimes making, you know, those folds, but once you will fit them to the spine and to decorate them with paper, they will like settle down, so it will be not too hard to work with them. Awesome. I've got piece for my spine as well. I will cut this a little bit for that one and half. Nice. I like it. So now I think I'm gonna make these edges nice. I'm not gonna distress this one at all because it has that old look already. So I'm gonna just glue it down. I'm not sure if I will glue it straight away or if I will make there something. But I know that this will be inside of my book. Like, that other side as well. To make that cover stronger. So now I'm gonna work on that cover. I'm gonna make this one like magnetic closure, this envelope with magnets. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna take two magnets. I'm gonna play, oi, come here. Oh, okay, nice. Somewhere here and somewhere here. Piece of paper. It's too small, okay. Do I have some piece smaller like this? You've got so many pieces of book pages, but nothing. Oh, I can use this one. Levis. Beautiful. And remember, be chaotic in creations. It's kind of normal. I'm gonna put there. I think I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller. This is too big. I'm gonna cut that piece. I'm sorry, I'm thinking. And yes, that's okay. I'm gonna make it a little bit smaller because for me it's too big. So I'm gonna make it, I think, 3 inches. Oh, are you gonna cut your face? Will I? I'm so sorry, Mr. Leslie. Some Mr. Leslie. No, he's okay. Look at him. Leslie. Charles II. Okay. And I'm gonna glue this on this space. So I'm gonna use wet glue. And I'm gonna place that wet glue on all these edges. Good. On all edges. I already have magnets there. On all edges. Come on. And also a little bit here. Make sure it will get glued properly. Oh, this will be too long video. And I am out of view. I'm gonna glue it down like this. Like this. And I don't like this one. I will place there some decoration. I'm gonna distress a little bit those edges and I will find some decoration what I will place here because I don't like this piece here. I'm talking and I just realized that I hit the camera, but I probably hit it on wrong space and I didn't took a video. So I used here, it's velvet ribbon. It's these self-adhesives stickers. They are like ribbons, very beautiful, perfectly sticking everywhere. is this one. And I found it on Every Crafts Pound. Maybe a year ago. And I've got still few left. And they are amazing, really beautiful decoration. So I use it here. And also, I half prepared, I put magnets on those magnets I glued already under that book page. And I cut paper in the size, I can slide it in. And I used my leftovers on my distress tool to see how big paper I need to cover this top front page. So now I'm gonna cut it just under this shape to make sure that I can glue it on my envelope. And before I will glue it, I have to glue down those magnets. For that, I'm gonna use Uhu glue. I'm gonna put a little bit of Uhu glue on these magnets. Show me. Yes, I think it's great. I think it will be okay. Okay. I'm gonna put a little bit of Uhu glue on those magnets. I'm gonna wait a little bit. Then I'm gonna flop it, glue these magnets here. With that Uhu glue, you have to wait a little bit to make that that glue. I'm not sure how to explain it. That glue, when it's drying, it's more sticky and it's faster drying. When you wait a little bit, then it's the item you wanna glue it down, it's not moving too much. If I will move it right now and I will wanna try to open that flop, it will open include with these magnets. But if I will wait a little bit and then flop it down, press it down on that envelope, and then I will lift this flop. These magnets will stay still here. So I'm gonna glue them down and then I'm gonna put on the top this paper and then we will continue together. So I've got glued down everything. This is magnetic now. I already cut 1.5 inch from that rest, from all pages. I cut 1.5 inch. I already cut these corners to make them pretty. I'm gonna glue it down. And I also prepared piece of leather, which I will glue down on my envelope, like this. I'm gonna use that Uhu glue. So when I will have glued down this piece of leather, and I'm gonna glue it down because I want to have that leather on the top. So when I will have glued down that leather, and also between my two envelopes on spine will be this stronger piece, I will be back. I've got that leather on my envelope. From this other side, this will be on the front. From that other side, I placed piece of book page. I already prepared a little bit smaller piece for that back cover. This is spine, so this will be on the back. I put double-sided tape in the middle. All around, I will put again that tacky glue and glue it down. And then I will have to think a little bit. Next step. Okay, so a few hours later, we finished dinner with my boys. I went with my dog. So I've got leather, I've got book pages here, I've got this magnetic closure here, and this piece here. That's it. It's not too many, is it? So for now, we're gonna continue with that cover. I'm gonna place the book page here, and I'm gonna glue it down on that all side. I'm gonna place this alongside for now. Here, I'm gonna use double-sided tape. Around, I will put liquid glue. I'm not sure why I'm placing liquid glue all around, probably because it's going too slow. I will have to make bigger hole. I will have to. This is too slow and it's driving crazy. I'm gonna put glue all on all these edges. all around. And I think because I want to wrap that book page also inside, I'm going to do it this way. And then I will fold it like this. I'm going to place my book page here to make sure it's kind of even. This. So small part of that book page will be inside of that pocket between my envelope and this piece, so it will peek out through to that pocket. I'm gonna put glue here as well, to glue it down. No, 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 not too many. Like this. Like this. Glue it down. Okay. And I guess I can fold it slowly. Yes. And I already prepared, you saw that on that book before I showed you for Patricia. I had that this embellishment. As you can see, I'm using this beautiful border embossing folder. It's from Crafter's Companion. This is company. And here, Crafter's Companion, oh, right here. Ornamental border embossing folder size. This is Shabby Chic. Oh, this one. And when you've got some piece which is not, which is longer than your embossing folder, I'm gonna show you. This is my piece I embossed. I'm not sure if you noticed that this end is a little bit different. I placed my piece of cardstock into that embossing folder. I went it through that embossing machine, and then this end wasn't embossed. It was plain, so I just, because I need to continue somehow this pattern, but I couldn't, you know, I couldn't place it there like this. I'm not sure how other ladies doing it. Maybe they cut pieces and then they glued them down. I just flip it over and I embossed it that opposite way. I know it's like negative of this one, this, but in that first view, you will have to have a look really properly to notice that, I guess. It doesn't seem on the first time. It's just continued all together. So I did this one. I'm gonna emboss. I'm gonna distress these edges. And then I prepared also this piece from book page. I prepared this piece. I used this die. It's dye from Tonic Studio. This dye is number here. This shutter die set. I can't tell you the name, but you can see that this is dyes from this collection. So I use this dye, and I prepared piece for my leather here. I'm gonna glue it down also. I'm just gonna cut it to the size of my leather. So I think I'm gonna cut piece here like this. It's gonna be here in this corner. I'm gonna follow probably this line like this, and maybe a little bit more on the bottom. Yes, a little bit more here on the bottom like this. Yes. So I'm gonna glue this using that Uhu glue. First, I will distress it a little bit also. And when I will have glued all this down, also this one and this one, I will come back to show you what you can create. So we are here. Oh, it's too many minutes. How you can change what I already did in that previous book. I was thinking to do it again in that grungy style, but a little bit with theme, because I found few images I've got. So what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna, here is my spine. I'm gonna make, I think, 4 holes here using this tool, and I'm gonna put there eyelets. We will see how it works. I think I will have to make marks from here. So I'm gonna use my ruler. I'm gonna measure. I'm gonna use a pen. And I'm gonna measure. This is 9 inches. So I think. Here is half of that, so I'm gonna make how many? I'm gonna put 2 holes here, one, I think in this position, one hole here, another hole here, another hole here, and another hole here. They will be a little bit down, but I think it will still work. And I will show you for what I'm gonna try. Now I have to put these marks right here. And what will help me is when this moving down, this point is moving down, I'm gonna move my envelope to that point to make sure that it will be in the middle. I'm not sure if you can see that. That I'm pointing my mark in the middle of that moving shape. Am I there? Yes! Okay, so this way. Oh, I'm somewhere else, isn't I? Where is it? Here is it. And it's a really easy tool to use. You just need to try it. So I'm gonna make the holes, and I'm gonna put there again those eyelets, and I will be back. I'm done. I've got my eyelets in. I put also this velvet ribbon, sticky adhesive or self-adhesive ribbon on that background. So I've got these eyelets. Also, I forgot to tell you, put book pages inside if you wanna do same like I do. Same journal like I do. Now, because I still want to have here 2 pockets, you forgot to do that. Here it's middle of my page, so at that point I'm gonna put a glue inside. It's good to have their book page, because then you can choose which part of those sentences it's kind of in middle, and continue on that sentence, on that line, and put there your glue, and you are sure you're in middle. That's a good point of using book pages. That they are helping you. So we've got our eyelets. I'm gonna use this natural thread to put it through the eyelets. This one, it's a beautiful natural thread I bring from France. It's really wonderful. So I'm gonna, it's long enough. I'm going to put it, I think I will wrap it here, so. Make together and go in, out, and I will explain why I'm doing this, because you can add to your cover pictures or some embellishment very easily, and around and again inside. Go there. Inside. Like this. Which way I am? This way. A little bit down. This way. In. I'm so sorry, it's too long. But many of you wanted to know how I am decorating my journals, and it's really long process. It is always for me really very long process because I think I'm thinking too much. I'm overthinking. So it's always very long process. Here I will put like embellishment this metal piece. I love metal, really, I do. That's why I've been a welder for many years. These pieces, I'm gonna put it around those two ends. Put it together. Those, I'm sorry, I don't know right word, but those ends, fold them inside, and then I'm gonna squeeze all that brat together, and then I'm gonna squeeze it to make it flat. And it looks vintage. Look at that. I hope you can see that it looks vintage. Now I can cut the edges of this. I'm sure it will stay still. And what I would like to show you, it's something what I promised while ago that I will show you how I made it. It's those specimens frames with butterfly inside. I promised that while ago when I made that natural style junk journal, and I had that there, that embellishment. So I'm gonna show you today. I'm using these dies. These are snapshot dies. I don't remember company, but these are snapshot dies. If you don't have them, you just need to cut out a rectangle from your cardstock, and inside of that rectangle, on one side, close to one side, draw a rectangle or a square, and left small piece on one side, and then cut that inside. I think it's mostly rectangle. Yeah, rectangle inside. And then cut it, start with knife, and then use your scissors. Or if you are strong enough to cut straight lines with the knife, just use the knife all the time. But I'm not strong. I still got that shaking in my hand. That's why I've been brilliant welder. Because you have to have shake in your hand. See, now I am going too fast. But if you will pay attention to this cutting out, you will make that frame as well. It will just take a little bit longer time. You know, like this, cut that frame inside, and you will end up with something like this. Steps, yeah. Find some insect images from this butterfly center book. I cut out two butterflies. One is small for this small frame, another is bigger. I glued them on book page because I want to have that backside nicely. Fussy cut out your butterflies, and then you will need some acetate piece. In this case, because you will don't put any pictures inside or take it outside, it will be glued all over, all together. You don't need so strong acetate piece. So I'm gonna use, this is piece from that album page. So I'm gonna use that. For gluing down, I'm gonna use glossy accent, if I will find it. Yeah, just bear with me. Yay, I found my glossy accent. So I'm going to glue one big frame and one large frame. Here is fold of my this foil or acetate piece. This is not acetate piece probably, but this is fold. So I'm gonna put that frame exactly on the edge of that fold, and I'm gonna glue it down. Also, this small frame, I'm going to glue it down, and I will be back. I glue it down. Now you need to cut, if you've got just one piece of acetate, just fold it half, then glue your one part of that frame. Cut it around. wrapped it around beautifully. I'm gonna show it on this one. Take your butterfly. Oops. Take the butterfly. Put it inside. Put the small amount of glossy accent. And fold that piece over it. And also put glossy accent in this space and on that frame. If you cut your frame yourself, maybe you cut this frame a little bit bigger, which is brilliant idea. So then you need to put just piece of acetate like a frame. You don't have to put all piece all around. And it will be much more easy, you know. Then take your other piece again. Use glossy accent or double-sided tape, wherever you will choose for gluing down on that acetate piece or on that plastic film. And put it all together and let it dry. And as I am working in vintage style, I'm gonna a little bit color this acetate piece as well. For that, I'm gonna use, where is it? Now I scared myself that I lost it. I'm gonna use this alcohol ink, and this is caramel color. So I'm gonna take just a small amount on my brush. Just a little bit on my brush. And I'm gonna like brush it around. It will put to that acetate piece that aged look. I will show you once I will be finished. Not too much, that caramel. It's really beautiful color for this one. You can use some dabber or some another tool what you are using for inks, for alcohol inks. Now I need a white card. See, we already have like vintage acetate. And for my frame, I'm going to use, oh, I forgot to close the accent. That's why it's not going outside. For that frame, I'm going to use the walnut stain. Hopefully it's dry altogether. Hopefully I will don't move it too much. And I'm gonna distress all these edges. And because I use that acetate, that acetate got stuck on that frame as well when I try to wipe it. And now it will make that vintage look on my frame, which is brilliant. Any kind of glue, see, I will show you, will make like marks on your frame, and then it looks very vintage. I know it's cheeky, but look at that. When you do it on purpose, it mostly doesn't work, but when you try to wipe glossy accent from your piece of paper or this beautiful frame, it mostly leave some marks on your cardstock, and then it makes your frame looks very vintage. So this way, see, it's amazing. it's like a happy accident. And now what I will do, I will finish this one later with that big butterfly, but it will be same process. What I will do now, I think I will hang that right here. Yes, I will put two eyelets to my acetate piece. So I'm going to make hole in this corner. Dan we hier. Like this. And on that opposite corner as well. I hope I will get the same position, hopefully. Hopefully. Yeah. Close. So close. I will put there. And let's. Okay. I will put these eyelets when I will pause my video, and I will be back probably when it will be done, because that acetate piece, it make it stronger. So I will be right back. I'm done. Now, using these rings, I'm gonna hang this beautiful specimen window to those threads, or what is it? Yeah, I think it's thread. I will also hang there some tags, which will looks like etiquette for this window, and then I will hang here that bigger snapshot with that bigger butterfly, and it will be. And it's a really gorgeous embellishment. It will look amazing. And if you will make some journal in this theme, I think it will be amazing to have that this like embellishment. I didn't let it dry properly. It started to get opening. Okay, I will have to put there a little bit more of glossy accent, I guess, to this frame. Okay. This video, it's already 1 hour long. I hope you will be not too upset that if I will switch it off for today. But I will be soon, really, I will be back really soon. See, even my brain doesn't work now. So I will be back really soon and we will continue with this journal. I hope you enjoy it, even it was just small part of this book. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. And see you next time. Bye.